Hello everyone and welcome back to Survive Chaos. We're gonna be playing with the Chaos mode because we want to play with a race. And yeah, it's gonna be a casual battle. And we got the Fel Orcs. So you guys can pick any bonus you want to see. We should be able to do dwarves early on, because they will overpower us in the late game. Yeah, it might be hard to get control of the battlefield since we also have to fight the strong Dark Horde early on. We'll see how it goes. We'll see. Hope all the settings are working correctly. If it doesn't, then please let us know. So we're not getting any requests just yet. So if you want to see a bonus, then please request them quickly, because there's a high chance you will be getting the because you want to see. Take a pick of random tier 3. Bullish magic. Yeah, it's not gonna help me. Especially not against Dwarves. Fel Fusion might just be a little bit better. Hey Lords of Zarma, nice to see you there. Federal Magi. Sure, why not? Let's do someone's request here. He's always supporting us for a long time already. So to me it makes perfect sense to be playing with the bonus he wants us to play with. He is going for some early unit upgrades. We're struggling a little bit early on the side lanes. This thing, realistically we want to apply the pressure to the dwarves. We'll play with the AWP effect, the small stun, next damage. Let's get one fell steel weapon so that we will be slightly keeping up with this guy. We should be able to control this battlefield here. We should apply more pressure to the annoying little dwarves. Twice we're mid lane. Unbelievable. And he's playing with Fanatics. So he went for strong bones there. But the dwarf casually upgrading mid lane first just asks to be heard early on. Hit a command picks this. So I might go for tier 2 barracks mid lane. So that he's not gonna be killing my units out quickly. Skull Crusade might be winning this with their strong Fanatics. But not Dwarf player going for the middle lane first. If that's not gonna be punished, then I don't know. At least we are going for it. Too bad that these Scarlet Crusaders are not applying pressure to him yet. One tier 2 against me and he used defense spell at the top. Interesting since he only had to deal with a tier 1 wave. Of course he had to go tier 2 here. But he's by X units. So he's losing some momentum that he built here at the middle lane. By being forced to buy some X units here. But he might go for big counter attacks, so we better be upgrading aggressively. Apply the pressure, make sure we can kill his counterattack before he gets a massive wave. We will be getting his reinforcements soon. At least a few hits to the workshop, I like that. That's probably not going anywhere just yet. Hey Avze, nice to be seeing you there. Wumai is the purple one. Yeah, he's taking it slow for now. He's just going for unit upgrades. Hopefully with the extra unit upgrade we got here compared to Dwarves, we'll hopefully be able to maintain possession. He might be having the orb upgraded. I think he does have it upgraded. But if we got way more unit upgrades, then this lane will at least be ours and the Mind's Armor and increased attack speed will be working in our advantage. Right, he better not have upgrade against me. I'm afraid he did. We'll see. Let's go for a risky maneuver here to go for the armor. My units will be nearly as strong as him, but he does have to tier 2 barrack stand. But the more he pushes on the side lanes, the less pressure we can give to Dwarves. Yeah, and he's going quickly here, so I assume he went tier 2 against me. No, he didn't. He didn't. Good news. He knew I was tier 2 against Dwarves, so maybe that's why he didn't do that. I think the Dwarves are still building up a major force. Look at them in middle lane. Good gods. Despicable Dwarves. Hey, Sus, nice to be seeing you there. We could technically try to get rid of his counterattack by using a tier 2 Inferno. I don't want the boss to be building any momentum. But then we would be tier 1 here against Wurmai a little bit longer. We'll probably upgrade against us, so that's be a little bit quicker than him. And this tower still helping him out, so yeah, I think this counter attack is gonna happen. And even if it goes tier 2, we should be able to stay in control here at least. Let's get 3-3 units, probably the cripple soon as well. Maybe some infused stones. It's also tier 2 mid lane. Interesting. Very, very interesting indeed. So I'll try on the ranged upgrades. We might be ignoring the infused stones. Normally I kind of like to be spamming the infernals. But I highly doubt that we can gain that much momentum. Especially since he can summon dragons. So might be using one infernals to get early battlefield control. And then I might be sending Gul'dan there. And then we might be leaving our ultimate weapon choice open. He has to go tier 2 here. So he's not gonna get that early hero like us. This fight not going anywhere, it's definitely my advantage, but yeah, this wave will hit us sooner or later. That's a no-brainer. Got a fortification upgrade, that's maybe why he couldn't upgrade yet. But there he is. And it's only a matter of time before he will counterattack. It's only a matter of time before this dwarven base will hit us. So those infernals will work out perfectly. For every lane soon. And since we might be skipping the infused stones, going for some unit upgrades, getting some army strength, might be the best way to proceed. There might only be tier 2 here, but we might have a strong army, so with the hero we might just be in good enough shape to be fighting every enemy at once. I'm just undecided yet whether I'm gonna be summoning Gul'dan or Jubaitos. Jubaitos could definitely wreck enemy heroes quickly, but he could also run off to one of the side lanes. Gul'dan is the safer choice. Right, that's Mirrodin. Or then maybe against tier 3 from the Fanatics. Would make decent sense for him to get the early tier 3 barracks everywhere with the insane damage from the Fanatics. Murder in middle lane. Yeah. Seems crazy. But it did happen. Unexpected. But oh well. Yeah, they can go invisible anyway, so it's ID Unholy Aura. I'm not too fond of all my units running a little bit too quickly, so let's go for the repulse. Cursing them, crippling them seems good here. And I do not want to buy any units. I just want the two infernals here. I want two infernals middle lane. I Yeah, we're gonna be more than fine here with the Infernals. I'd rather not risk losing a hero to this wave. Okay, that was a bit risky, but we played that out nicely. We couldn't wait that much longer with the Infernals there. Should be fine here. We will maintain control over there. Let's just keep on upgrading. We want the multi-shot soon. Chaotic swings, perhaps. For some extra damage. So let's begin with this one. We did send out one hero, but that's also mirrored in. We should have the strong army here. So this hero kill will be ours. Was could only potentially save Murden with possible tier 3, and that's probably not even gonna be enough. So a good moment for us there. So we're on tier 2 everywhere again, and the enemies are tier 2 against me everywhere too. This will just work out nicely. But the fact that we can counter attack here with those Infernos is just so good. I think we're on 6 attack already. So time to get some extra armor. And then we might even be getting the same flame before getting the first fortification upgrade. We'll see. That Inferno didn't even die. Or did didn't he? Oh Jesus! He's feeling the pain. Went a little bit too aggressive with that hero summoning. Then might just be doomed a little bit as well. We're gonna be losing some gold there soon enough. So we need to get our gold elsewhere. 4 dragons there, that's kinda scary. Reducing enemy armor is gonna be good now. Let's get one if we use stones. Double hero. Oh, he's crazy. That should be enough to counter attack us, I suppose. I might be sending a hero here since there are 4 dragons. At least we are gonna get the DK aura. Not just for the gold, but the DK aura will work out nicely there. Well, I didn't even do my hair. I did. I just woke up like this. But yeah, thank you, GG. I don't know how to pronounce that correctly, so my apologies for ruining your awesome name. Ah, Born to Odin with mid lane. Fortunate for us. I don't really want Grommash to take all the damage here. Let's get the Chaotic Swings. Again. We got some good damage with those Fire God Brutes, so we need to be cautious. See if we can kill him quickly. Actually, we don't mind losing a few units at the middle lane, but rather get rid of those pesky dragons a little bit quicker. Pretty much will counter attack there, but I think it was a fine move to get him out. I think Necrush was summoned, so that's a bit of a nuisance. There he is. Oh no, it's Dalrent. Alright, so Godan might not be looking too great right now, but my arm is strong. Tier 3 here might just be good enough to get both hero kills. Keep Godan alive. Edward's Godan might just be attacking the Crusaders, but I wouldn't mind applying pressure to the Fanatics at all, so maybe, just maybe, we do not even need a tier 3 barracks here. I'd rather be safe than sorry. Yeah, the Dwarf Nail ran away. A bit unfortunate for us there. We got a momentum. No need to risk losing our momentum here. Lauren might be getting the hero kill there. That would be unfortunate for us. Look at poor Gul'dan. He's taking all the hits. I think we made the right move to go tier 3 in middle lane. And he's playing with hero items, so interesting choice there. Right, at least more Antonin is gonna fall. Dalrent got the hero kill. That's just the luck we need. Let's get 6 armor. Dalrent also killed our hero. Well, well played by Womai. Neck rush, but he's taking some damage here. Negros did summon out a Drake. But yeah, we do not want the Darkwood to control the middle lane, so I might just be sending Jibaitos. Jibaitos is not gonna have the easiest time against tank. Was there 3 middle lane? Yeah, I don't mind having the Dwarf's life a little bit longer because he's gonna be pressuring the Crusaders for us. Yeah, I would like the Infernals, but if we do, we are gonna get the easy hero kill here, which I want, but we also gonna be buying time for Necrush. That's not gonna be ideal. So yeah, Jibaitos is gonna struggle a little bit there. And if he wants to be a hero, he will need to fight himself out of tough situations. Bloodlust could be very useful soon. Yeah, it's gonna be taking damage. No doubt about that. But we'll be very unlucky if the Dwarves would actually attack us. And of course they are. We'll be very unlucky if we are not gonna get a hero kill there. At least we got him. I'm sending Gul'dan here. It's gonna be tougher for the Dark Horde to defend him. So if these Scarlet Crusades are not controlling the middle lane, I'm perfectly fine with the flow of the game. We could also defend him without a hero. That might actually even be better. I'll do what I take. Let's go tier 3. He might still be willing to buy himself time with heroes. Brand's gonna go middle lane. Should be a fun hero kill for us. Oh, Jesus, man. Random people. Loving it. So we will have to deal with the Scarlet Crusaders now. If he's tier 3 against me or even tier 4, then that's gonna suck. Even skipping out on Brand right now. Wonderful. Searing Flame, sure. Got no extra spells though. Need the Fel Fusion. Let's get the Demon Blast is gonna be good, but I kinda want the increased attack speed. Yeah, look at that. We will have to deal with this wave, which we otherwise would have never to deal with. Jibaitos might even realistically have gone for the Scarlet Crusades, which he might otherwise not have done it. An allied champion is fallen. Gul'dan and Gromash can hold line left side. We got the Fel Orcs, the veteran Magi. To go middle lane. Yeah, we can send Gul'dan here. Let's have Getty Dark Horde will attack soon in the middle lane. Don't waste my time. You'll be executed. want them to the barracks. There we go. But then it's gonna go for a slow counter attack, I hope. Let's go for some defensive upgrades then. Sucks, but what can we do? Doggo might be getting this hero kill, which might have been ours. Could go for a risky hero middle lane, but that's only gonna be worth if we get two hero kills. Let's give it a chance. As long as Cho'Gath's gonna be aiming for us, it's not gonna be likely to kill Bran. He got enough health to deal with the Crusaders for now. He's definitely investing a lot of mana on those dragons. Should be able to kill them. No hero here yet. Maybe Bran cannot hold the Scarlet Crusaders. At least we did prevent Cho'Gath from getting a hero item and experience there. Those dragons will help him out though. That's annoying. Doom blood, some X regeneration, increased attack rates. All good. Third goal probably not looking too bad either. Ooh, look at that barracks. No area yet. We did destroy those dragons. He might be overrun here. He needs tier 3 quickly. He doesn't have gold. He went for the hero. That's gonna be enough for him, not for now. He needs to be very, very cautious on that bottom lane. Let's get stones. Of course, man, of course. He had the overpower. Yeah. Of course he had to go. Maybe it's true, maybe he has an emergency, maybe he had to go. Could be true. Could be true, that's all I'm saying. The Crusaders might be getting that hero kill now. We would have been able to kill that barracks easily, and if we wouldn't have been able to kill it easily, we could have nuked him down. Not just me against the Crusaders. Which is a shame. Go with the spell shield. Let's go with the slow against the Crusaders. Did to spell. Finally, he's tier 3. Grommish is still gonna attack him here, but he should be fine to defend it. This Cho'Gath will be ours for the taking. Got to do mages, yeah, that's gonna be hard to fight, so we definitely need the Fel Shield up. Good on doing a good job over there. Got the Swings level 3. It's tier 3 everywhere, we're tier 3 and tier 2. Yeah, I don't know. Depends on how long the Scarlet Crusaders will be staying in the game. Maybe it will beat me up. Just depends on how long this game will last, of course. But if he's not gonna fall too quickly, we might be playing another game. It shouldn't be too hard for her to defend for him. This might be a little bit more annoying, but he can't simply send a hero or buy a few units. There are not gonna be too many unit spawns anymore this game, since we got two long lane sides and that causes you to spawn less units over time. Less gold to come. So yeah, if we will overpower him soon, and that's gonna be great. Ooh, that's a very risky tier 3 Citadel upgrade. At the moment you're under attack. Might be better off to buy a hero here. Very, very risky upgrade. We will survive, I suppose. But I was definitely not recommend to do to get this upgrade when you're on siege. Yeah, we can take out for the nuke. We might still be higher on unit upgrades, yeah, just a little bit, but he does have the Fnatic, so he does potentially have a stronger force than us. So we cannot we can go easy on him. Maybe using these guys. Yeah, let's do it. We still should be able to go for double nuke soon, destroy this right barracks. He might go for that special unit. But we do have strong enough heroes to deal with it. So I'm not overly concerned. Well, let's stack up for nuke and then we will deal with him. And we're on Tito here, so we should be able to get more gold. But those Infernals should be enough to allow us to take possession of the War Mill, which is what we kind of want. Precious side lanes. He will need a hero here to survive. But he took so much unnecessary damage there. Yeah, that's the hero he kind of needed. Let's get another Fel Blades. And he might still be losing this barracks soon. Maybe some Fellfire arrows. Alright, those events will be out of tower range, but I don't think they will be slaying Sally. If we only had the War Mill, this would probably have been destroyed. I'm sure someone can do the math for sure. Yeah, we need this, but I'm not gonna go for it yet. Probably get the tier 3 keep, level 7 base unit upgrades first. He's probably lacking the gold to send out Ember anytime soon. With 6 fortifications though, so he is getting decent gold for that. No, might be losing this one against Gudan. Gudan is 7 levels higher. Gudan can heal himself. Maybe he can save by buying a lot of units. Who knows? Yeah, we need just a little bit of extra mana for the nuke. For double nuke, but we still need time. I knew there was a mana fountain somewhere. It is. This wave will attack us. No, might be able to survive it. Oh, the tower is helping him out. That's good news for him. I thought he would be out of tower range. By the way, no, it's not gonna be in good shape. Please throw down one Vernal. Nope, not happening. An allied champion has fallen. So we need a hero here. We can defend this without a hero if we want to. But we require a hero. Now we can defend this without a hero as well. But we either need a hero on the left side. Oh, that's Ember. Alright. So are we gonna go for that smite? We can smite him. Well, maybe we are gonna go for the challenge. Try defending without a smite. Go for that double nuke. Although that might be a little bit risky. Let's just smite and buy hero in the middle lane to deal with him. Then we will throw down the Infernals, I suppose. He could nuke sooner or later if he wants to, but if we get him destroyed, get the gold. He did invest a lot of gold for him, so Yeah, Gudon just sucks.
Research complete.
There we go. The map is a little bit of fun there. It may be we Red's going a little bit too aggressive there. Expect a little bit more from him. We should be able to clear these fall enemies. And I don't know why Renault actually got redirected, but his army didn't. That looked a little bit crazy to me. Let's get the fall boulders, it's more damage to the enemies, even on the base. Let's get the fell fire arrows. Then this barracks will burn down unless he sends an early amber. We should have done better to defend our base there. Not much certain. But it's was odd that his army was not getting redirected. One stack up with the nuke. Then do it. I want to get tier 4 bear soon enough. But I think his army should have been redirected. They shouldn't have gone for that portal. I wouldn't mind not having an army here, an army there without a hero. That'd be annoying for him to deal with. Let's get the Fel Shield upgraded. Probably want the Demon Blood upgraded as well. Yeah, he's going for that early Amber. Interesting move. You see, we're not gonna be getting too much gold for the unit upgrades. We are. Hopefully, that's gonna benefit us. Chrome is not getting too many reinforcements though. So maybe it's better to keep spamming special units. And even though the fanatics are not that high on those unit upgrades, they're strong enough to probably deal with us. Let's forget he can smite anytime he wants to. Noah's probably gonna survive this again. This time around, the ballista towers are not hitting Gul'dan, but. Yeah, he's not having too many reinforcements. And those fanatics everywhere, man. God, they're tough. So we just want this barracks on tier 4, I suppose. And then Amber hitting the keep. I think that's the way we should try to defend the right side. We could upgrade this to tier 4, but we are not getting too many units there anyway. But look at that. We're miles ahead, and he's still winning there. Upgrade. Yeah, that's just how strong the fanatics are. We even got the level 2 Fel Shield soon. Should get us into a better position, of course. But it's incredible how much we actually do struggle with the Crusaders. Looking at the difference at research there. More than 25% more research. This wave's spawning at a really bad time for us. We can easily send a hero to deal with this. Shouldn't be a problem for him at all. But it knows it's gonna be annoying. I think we might have to go for smite here soon. Was there something you wanted? Definitely want him hitting the keep. But he might be splitting. Of course he splits that moment. And of course now we cannot redirect. No reinforced middle lane. That was what we were hoping for. Of course this wave spawning at a really bad time as well. So it might actually be a better option now to go for the Infernals. Should be sufficient, I would say. Maybe should be going tier 4 here. He's still 4 mil lane. yeah, that's gonna be a problem. We'll be coming in soon. 4 infernals on the right side, so that's not gonna be buying me time in mid lane either. If force him into the Insta-Mite, we will be safe from his nukes. I will also be giving him gold. Not looking forward to that. We'll be getting more gold in 12 seconds. So let's take the risk. Sally is tough to redirect. This wave will be once again spawning a bad time. But what's new? Bunch of demons. Man, oh man, oh man. Yeah, those fanatics are just one of the strongest bones in the game. That's just a big pain in the ass to deal with. Took more damage here than we had to. We really sucked with that redirection. But overall, my defensive skills slightly lacking these days. Seems like someone is trying to wake up. Right, no, way too early here. He's on tier 3. Amber on the long lane. Instinct move, that's gonna apply a lot of pressure there. Maybe should go for the magic rune. It's a lot of gold. That's probably the best way for us to deal with Ember. I don't know why he actually went for no. But for some reason no is doing a really good job against Gul'dan over and over again. Well, we will attack to the middle lane with Grommash. We're attacking here with Gul'dan. Yeah, it's... we're only tier 2 there. Betting on... enough gold for the magic rune is gonna be really risky. He's all sending Sally too early to die. Probably trying to buy time. In the snow. Three fanatics. Yeah, that's bringing in quite some damage there. But he spent nearly 5,000 gold here. To send Amber and double heroes there. Right, he might struggle defending this one. Unless we jit. Ah, Tito spell. But will it be enough? Probably. Good redirection there. This guy's actually a little bit better than I expected. Good for him. Hopefully with this redirection we're gonna be able to destroy this barracks. It's on fire, but Brigitte is a true hero for him. Yeah, he still lost it. The barrel might be sufficient. And we will always have Jibaitis on the middle lane. He's gonna go tier 4 here, trying to push through. At least we should be safe here. We got way more research. Yeah, Grom is certainly gonna fall. He will need a hero there. Our sacred world is being desecrated. Good, and also just one sock, Ember. I think we're good. Despite the minus, when you ignore the minus 10% building hit points for the Fel Orcs, they're actually one of the strongest races defensively. Even if you take us for the nuke, you will need to do it quickly. My Ember is growing increasingly powerful. It's very tricky for us. Still go for Mana Rune sooner or later. Let's get the Fel Shield. Get the Fel Sap and Bloodlust. Both kind good. I was gonna fell there soon enough. Fell Blades. Yeah, I kinda want to upgrade that even more. He's leaving. Third person giving up against the might of the Fel Orcs. Loving it. So, we might not have been playing our best game here. But we did win. A bit disappointing that the Dwarves have left. If he stayed in the game, he probably would have applied way more pressure to the Scarlet Crusade. Would have caused them way more trouble. Didn't happen. The fact that the Fel Orcs were able to keep fighting us with the army strength, despite having 25% less research, just says how powerful those fanatics are. Well, we played through the game quite easily. I think we played well. We just should have defended our base a little bit better than we did. We took some unnecessary damage. But overall, I think we played the cleanest game there. And still, if the Scarlet Crusade stayed, he would have had the chance to look me down. He just needed more research. He just gambled on Ember and possibly Smite. He should have found more ways to deal with us. But hey! We did it. Nice victory there. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I'll gladly see you all next time. Bye bye.